Hello everyone, I am Dharam Radhachandra, MPhil second semester students, Nepal Open University, Kathmandu. Today, in this video, I am going to talk about the essay written by Talal, Asad, the concept of cultural translation in British social anthropology. Let's first know the writer. Talal Asad was born in 1932 in Saudi Arabia and he was raised in Pakistan. In 1989, Asad moved to the United States and got his academic degree from Oxford. Then he became a distinguished professor of anthropology at the City of New York Graduate Center. He had made lots of contribution in various fields. Such fields include colonialism, Christianity, Islam, ritual studies, and so on. Presently, he is working on an anthropology of secularism. His ideas were influenced by postmodern philosophers, Friedrich Nietzsche, Michel Foucault, and others. In this article, Talal Asad states the anthropological interest in language and translation. In other words, we can say that he sees the work of translation from the anthropological point of view. His focus was mainly on the translation of culture. While we translate language, we not only translate language, but we translate culture. Because language is one of the main parts of culture. Asad says, translation is a matter of learning to live another form of life and to speak another kind of language. Anyone concerned with translation from other cultures must look for coherence in discourse. It means while translating one cultural text to another language, there must be coherence between two languages. Talal Asad talks about two main points in cultural translation. They are the inequality of languages and reading other cultures. Let's first talk about the inequality of languages. All good translation seeks to produce the structure of an alien discourse within the translator's own language. Translation and translators must try to reproduce the structure of alien discourse, which means a source language discourse, within the translator's own language, means target language. The language of translation must give voice to the intention of the original, not the reproduction. In other words, translation should not look like a reproduction. It must look like the original text. It must carry the intention of the original text, the original writers. Translation work should always precede a critique and enlarge and make it more coherent. But it was found that most of the translators translate the remote language text on the best knowledge of their own, not foreign. In other words, most of the translators, even we are translating some remote language text into our standard language without understanding deeply to the cultural values of the remote languages. Therefore, translators must understand the word, image, and tone coverage of the source language while translating. Talal also focuses on translators should expand and deepen their language by means of foreign language. He means the translator or the anthropologist, must lead the life of the foreign language. And what people say through their language, he should understand the intention. And later he should make some changes in his own language from the foreign language. Only then he can do the best translation. Transforming one's own language by the translator is not an easy task, as I just said. But the languages of the third world are weaker in relation to Western languages. There is hegemony power. They are made weaker. Weaker languages are more likely to forcible transformation in the translation process. Because Western nations have greater ability to manipulate the third world countries, and Western languages produce and deploy desired knowledge. He has given the examples of Arabian, two remote Arabian languages in his essay. Industrial capitalism transforms not only modes of production, but also kinds of knowledge and styles of life in the third world. And here, an unskillful Western translator may simplify the direction of his own strong language, and ambiguities occur in translation. The translation does not carry its original meaning. To overcome such problem from the anthropological concept of translation, Asad suggested the translator to go on experiments in modes of ethnographic representation. As I earlier said, translators should go and live and speak the source language and modes of their lives just as a child does in learning to grow up with a specific culture. When they adapt as adulthood, their learning becomes implicit. Only then they can translate. They return to their countries, they write up, or means they translate the text, foreign language text, and they translate it for their readers who were waiting to know another form of life. Readers are not only waiting to read the language, but they want to read or know another form of life. Therefore, cultural translation must accommodate itself to a different language and its mode of life. Thank you. And the rest of the part will be discussed by my colleague. Thank you very much.